Let's start off. The first person who's going to speak is Jenny Foley. She's the founder and visual effects producer for the Creative-Cartel. With over 30 years' experience in the visual effects and animation industry, Jenny has produced and managed visual effects for filmmakers and studios. She founded the Creative-Cartel, a Los Angeles-based production company specializing in the assembly of teams tailored specifically for the visual effects and animation needs of individual productions. Under her guidance, the company oversaw all the visual effects and animation for last year's TED. Prior to this, produced both the visual effects and 3D conversion of Ghost Rider, The Spirit of Vengeance. She and her team are oversaw the visual effects on After Earth and handled digital pipeline for Grown Ups 2. Before forming the Creative Cartel, Jenny worked as executive vice president of production and executive producer for Sony Pictures Imageworks. While at Imageworks, she managed digital production on a number of films, Surf's Up, Chronicles of Narnia, The Lion, The Witch, and the Wardrobe, Spider-Man, and Spider-Man 2. Some of her other credits include Open Season, Charlie's Angels, Bad Boys 2, The Matrix Reloaded, The Matrix Revolutions, I Am Legend, Stuart Little, The Aviator, Hancock, and Ghost Rider. But this is my favorite credit of all. Jenny was born in San Francisco and raised in Marin County. Her earliest national accomplishment was at the age of 11, when after a lengthy court battle, she won the right for girls to play Little League baseball and was the first girl in the United States to actually play. And that. And she didn't just play. She led her league in home runs that year. So, take it away, Jenny.
I didn't actually win the right for the girls to play. They were just to clear up the record. We almost bankrupted Little League, so they were having all these battles all over the country, and only one went to Supreme Court. They picked a very conservative area, but meanwhile, a judge locally said, "National Little League, you can't use public fields unless you let her play." So I was the only girl to play that year, and then in New Jersey, Supreme Court opened it up for all girls. So that's the official story. So when she said I have 30 years experience, she meant 13, because I'm only 32. Yeah. I actually started my career in 1980 as a janitor for George Lucas at ILM. I came in during the tail end of Empire Strikes Back. Went from night janitor to day janitor to mailroom, which was a gigantic promotion for me. And the first show I actually did was as production assistant on Star Trek IV. So it's been a few years. It's actually been a really amazing ride. One of my favorite movies when I was in high school, I used to go to the Rocky Horror Picture Show every Friday night at midnight. And then, of course, I did Empire Strikes Back as I was cleaning the trash cans, but I was still there, part of it. It takes a village. But I just recently, on After Earth, got to work with Peter Shishitsky, who was our director of photography. And he was the director of photography on Rocky Horror Picture Show and Empire Strikes Back. And so I got to, we actually ended up having a very great relationship. He and my partner share recipes for bread now and things like that. And you know, it's when you look back in retrospect, it's really been an amazing ride, and there's been a lot of really amazing opportunities and a lot of really incredible people along the way. So I worked at ILM for a long time, and I was a coordinator up there. I've done Roger Rabbit, which is of Eastwick. And I was always kind of going to be little Jenny the janitor, so I needed to spread my wings and move on a little bit. What are you laughing at? So I came down to LA and I went to work at DreamWorks. And I did Total Recall, and that kind of started. I had been at ILM for 8 years, so I had taken roots, and I probably would have stayed there forever if I didn't feel like I couldn't shake that little Jenny the janitor thing. So I came down here and I started kind of leading a more, not nomadic because I was still staying put in Los Angeles, but more of a freelance mentality, company to company. And I think that I've pretty much worked at every visual effects company that's of size that's ever existed. DreamWorks, Digital Domain, Boss Films, Warner Digital, Sony Imageworks. It's been a long ride, and that experience has actually been really good for me, I think, as a visual effects producer, learning how different people do things and really getting to taste a lot of different flavors and being able to kind of find what I think works best. As Karen mentioned, I spent 11 years at Sony Imageworks as EVP of production, and that was also an amazing ride. It was definitely what I would consider the heyday of Imageworks, though there's nobody from Imageworks here, right? They were great times. It was a great time in the industry as well. We did all the Spider-Man movies, Hancock, I Am Legend, some work on The Matrix. It was just an incredible time. We did our first animated feature, which was Open Season, and then we did Surf's Up, which got pretty good reviews. And yeah, so it was a great ride. But the industry was changing, and it continues to change. When I started, we were still doing opticals, but when we moved into digital, there was really not a lot of places where you could learn how to do what we did. There were only a handful of schools, and they were out of reach for probably a lot of people who would be interested in learning about doing visual effects. The software didn't exist. It was up to the visual effects companies to develop those workflows and that software to be able to continue pushing the envelope and doing the work. And the hardware was really, really expensive. In the last 5 years especially, that has changed so much. You know, there are online schools. I'm sure that you guys come from all over the world. There are a lot of different ways that you can learn how to do visual effects. Hardware has become far more affordable, and software, you know, what last year had never been done before and won the Academy Award within a year or two, that's now usually available as off-the-shelf software. So the industry was really changing, and I felt like I wasn't able to help steer Imageworks in a way that I wanted to see. Myself go to keep up with the changing community of digital artists and visual effects folks. So I left and I started the Creative Cartel. Sorry, I get cotton mouth, I get nervous. I'm not stoned, I swear. So I started the Creative Cartel, and the Creative Cartel was really, we're a team of production folks. We stay creatively agnostic because I believe through my years of experience, you can have an Academy Award winning, you can have a multiple Academy Award winning supervisor, and if you put him with a director and the chemistry's not right, it can literally come to blows. I've seen it happen, literally, where they bump chess. You guys probably know what movie that was. Yes. It was not DJ. This, even though he's sitting like this and it looks like he could be that guy, he's not. I thought he was going to be wearing the stormtrooper costume with the codpiece. I'm a little disappointed. Oh, sexy. So anyway, I believe that in the new world, that it's best to cast things. You know, it's you know, a supervisor needs to understand a director's creative vision, needs to understand the aesthetic, and then needs to know the best path to get there. And that's not a one size fits all. I'm the same for artists now. There have, you know, with our industry becoming so global, we have a lot of options for getting work done these days. And I think that it's important also to match the companies and the artists with the project and the type of work that you need to do. So having the Creative Cartel, which is a small company, it enables me to do that very nimbly and very effectively, I think. One of the other things that we've done is, one of the issues that I've had for the last several years is kind of our whole workflow. The analogy that I use is if making movies is from going to point A to point B, for the last 70 to 100 years, we've been traveling on Route 66. And if you're a student from another country, you probably don't get that. I apologize. So we've come up with some software that kind of brings us into the 21st century with the digital workflow and digital technology. And it was kind of accidental. We started writing tools for ourselves at the Creative Cartel and realized that all of a sudden we had kind of a whole package that took digital images from camera all the way through to final DI and really streamlined and made the process much more effective and on par with the technology that we're using. So I certainly never set out to do that. And I only talk about it now because I want to plug my software, even though you're students, but also because there are a ton of opportunities for us now. If the industry is changing a lot, but that to me means there's opportunity for figuring out how to best adapt and help the industry move forward into its whatever it's going to look like in the next 5 years. I think it's going to look different than it's looked in the last 5 years, but to me that's very exciting, and you guys are in a good place. I'm not sure how it looks. You know, I don't know. Are you guys artists? Are you production folks? Are you technology folks? But there's definitely a lot of opportunity, and I think that the path is probably not the one that we've been trudging down for the last 10 years, but it's a new path that hopefully folks like yourselves will be able to help define and create for us. So I think that's all I have. All right.